friends, today we are going to make our LDR robot. So first we will see the program, then we will see about the robot. So here we have again our same robot base. So this is the program, INTR motor 1. So right side motor 1, right side motor 2, left side motor 1, left side motor 2. So these are declared the pins 5, 6, 10, 9. So respectively you have to just connect the pins. Okay, then INT speed 255. So today we are going to just use, here analog write. We actually use digital write, but today we are going to use analog write. So that's why we have just declared and made a variable that speed, and that's 225. I will tell you about analog write later. But let's see the program. Now here all our output serial.begin 9600. We are going to print on serial monitor. Then here the loop starts. INT LDR left, LDR right. So here like this our robot is going to look. Okay. So this is the right. Okay. So this one is the right and this one is the left. So the left one, as per the program, as the program says, the LDR left means the left one is going to be on 7. So this is the left one. So this will be on pin number 7, and this is the right one. So this is going to be on pin number 8. Okay, so like this. So then we will again move to program. If LDR both LDR right and LDR left are 0, then move forward. So what does it mean when both we are making light follower robot? Yes. So if both LDR is getting right, it is showing going to show 0. So our robot is going to move forward that time in direction of light. And if this right side it is light and left side it is not light, so it's going to turn on right side and turn right. And if left side it is light, so it is going to turn on left side. And then if there is it is darkness, nothing is there, light source is not there, so then it is going to just stop. Okay, I will show you. See, so here you have used a move forward parenthesis, so it will just go to, if this statement is correct, so this will just go to here, void move forward. Okay, so like this it works. And as we have declared 255 for our speed, so analog write R motor 1 speed. Okay, so that's 255. I'm going to tell you that in digital write we are just saying high and low. So for low it is, in analog write it is 0. And in analog write you can change the speed of motor. So we have kept the full speed, that is 250. So this is the speed, full speed, that is 255. So that's our full speed, and that's what is high. So we have just keep it high. So actually no need to write the analog write here, we can also write the digital write, but to explain you what is analog write, we have just write it here. Then for moving forward, these both will go speed. So both motor will going to just move forward. Now here in turn right, as for turn right, in R motor this one is going to, and in left side motors there is second. Okay, so what is this time? So this time it is something change new. So in turn right, so assume this is a robot. Okay, so in this robot if you want to turn right, so this is a right side, so the robot is going to move this side. Okay, so for that this time we are, whatever we are doing, that we are just saying the right wheels, both right motors are going to move anti-clockwise and the left side motor are going to move clockwise. So it will just like this, it is there, and it will just rotate like this. It will just rotate and come to the direction of light. So in this situation, the position of robot is not changing much. So that's why we have just used like this in this one. So again, we are here on our program. So here turn left. So for turn left, it is just same as turn right. We are just going to move the right side motor anti-clock, right side motor clockwise and left side motor anti-clockwise. So it will just turn towards left. And if there is nothing, as I have said, if there is no light, then it is void move stop. So as I have said here, if both at both LDR there is no light, then it will stop. So for stopping, it is here that all are zero. Okay, so let's see how our robot works. Okay, so like this, we have done all the connections here. We have fixed all the wires, and these both are LDR here. So we are just going to use this mobile torch as for our light source. So here you can see when the light falls on both LDR, so two lights are activating on each LDR. Okay, so like this. So we just have to connect this power bank here to just give it power. Okay, so let's see how it works. So you can see when the light is falling on both the sensors like this, it is moving forward. And as for our next program, then when the light will fall on this sensor, only right sensor, you can see it's just moving right side. Okay, like this, it's moving right side. Okay, I will show you again. When the light only falls on this right sensor, it's just moving right side. Okay, and when the light falls on left sensor, it is just moving left side. So like this, our program works. Thank you.